try and raise the tone a little here by singing a nice intellectual song for those two or three of you in the audience.
Right.
Who understand these things. So here we go.
Immanuel Kant was a real pissant who was very rarely stable. Heidegger was a boozy beggar who could drink you under the table. David Hume could out-consume Schopenhauer and Hegel. And Wittgenstein was a beery swine who was just as sloshed as Schlegel. There's nothing Nietzsche couldn't teach about the raising of the wrist. Socrates himself was eminently pissed.
How'd you like that, all right?
Let's hold it a second. I can see some of these Bruces are in a bit of a playful mood tonight.
Yeah, you know, Bruce? I can see some of them, yeah.
Some of the ones that don't have straws up their nose. Anyway, why don't we do something rather fun? Why don't we get some of these guys to sing along with
sing
us?
Sing along.
Okay? Some of the Sheilas too.
See, that's wise, okay.
Be really free.
Tell them the words,
okay, I've got the words somewhere.
Right.
Ready.
Immanuel Kant was a real pissant who was very rarely stable.
I beggar was a boozy.
They're a typical Hollywood audience.
Right.
All the kids are on drugs and all the adults are on roller skates. Have we got anything bigger to put the words up for these rather short-sighted people?
This is Bruce from the biology department.
All right.
Here we go.
Hey, Emmanuel
Kant was a real pissant. It was very, very stable.
Oh, come on!
Boozy beggar who can take you under the table. David Duke got our consumed. So an hour and Hegel. And Wittgenstein was a beery swine who was just as lost as stable. There's nothing Nietzsche couldn't teach about the raising of the wrist. Socrates himself was permanently pissed.
Take
your fill of his own free will. On Arthur Punch, and he was particularly ill. Plato, they say, could stick it away. Half a grain of whiskey every day. Aristotle was a bugger for the bottle. Hobbes was fond of his dram. And René Descartes was a drunken fart. I drink, therefore I am. Yes, Socrates himself is particularly his. Ah, lovely little thinker, but a bugger when he's pissed.
Hey,
good morning. I'm sorry to have kept you waiting, but I'm afraid my walk has become rather silly recently, and so it takes me longer to get to the office. Now, what was it again?